All this week, our man Mike Randall has been putting forth a musical question.
And that question is, can Randall rock?
You bet. Tonight, the moment of truth. Through the magic of the live eye, we take you to Desiderio's restaurant, where Mike is about to prove he's got the right stuff.
You're right, Irv. In just a few seconds, I'm going to be up here on stage in my spandex pants singing live with Strider. Now, I did that a couple of weeks ago, and we'll be showing you that in just a second. Also with me here are some folks from Camp Good Days and Special Times. They're selling our special record, Randall Rocks. On the flip side is the Eyewitness News Wrap. All the proceeds go to Camp Good Days and Special Times, so we hope we sell a ton of them. Now, so far it looks like the record's going pretty good, but things didn't start out that well.
It sounded pretty bleak.
Try to believe.
But with the expertise of a rock band called Strider and the musical direction of Dick Bowerly at Select Sound Studio, things started sounding a little better.
In case you haven't heard the news, I'm a rock and roll rebel.
The longer I sang my song, the more I could imagine what it would be like to be a real rock singer. Traveling first class, convincing the disc jockeys to play my record.
And you guys will play it, won't you?
Now,
please. The fans, the talk show circuit, the personal appearances, the... Wait a minute. There was something missing. An audience. It's one thing to sound like a rock and roll singer, but it's another to try to convince a real live audience.
Stand in one spot and just move back and forth.
Glenda Chase, lead singer from Strider, taught me a few moves.
Rock and roll rebel.
And Mike Runo shared a few words of advice.
You gotta relax. The more you're relaxed on stage, the better your performance. You know?
Drummer Johnny Magnum provided the last thing I needed before I went on stage before a live audience. Spandex pants.
There's another side down in this man's soul. There's Jekyll and Hyde.
Mom, Dad, forgive me.
It was at Desiderio's Halloween night, as the band was introducing me as a singer from L.A., that I considered taking up something easier than being a rock star, like skydiving, but it was too late for that.
Accent. Pretty good.
I'm serious. You sang really good.
The only one happier than me that it was finally over was my wife. Well, almost over. You see, every record has a flip side. So tomorrow night, hear Irv Weinstein say,
listen, party people, and don't be late. You'll always get the scoop. I give it to you straight. I'll give you the news that you need to know on Western New York's number one news show.
Folks, the record is on sale at Cabbage's Record Theater, Video Factory, the lobby at Channel 7, and tonight, here at Desiderio's, we have 200 copies, so come on down. See, if you'll excuse me now, I have to get into my spandex pants. I have a show to do. Back to you folks at the station.
That's great. Incidentally, those records are only $2.
For proceeds.
Proceeds go to Camp Good Days.
Have a great weekend here.